It has been a raw debate in this country in recent months. The place of Sir John A. Macdonald in Canadian history. His legacy as Canada's first Prime Minister is tremendous, but that legacy, we know, includes the creation of the residential school system. There's a new survey just out this morning that suggests, despite that fact, the majority of Canadians still support Sir John A. remaining in the public eye. Cameron McIntosh explains.
Most Canadians see his face every day. Sir John A. Macdonald, father of Confederation, first Prime Minister of Canada, immortalized here on the $10 bill and on building names, street names, and statues all across this country. Still, his nation-building policies had some negative effects: displacement and starvation of First Nations and Métis people, and the Chinese head tax. But when it comes to Sir John A.'s legacy, 70% of Canadians say he should stay in view, including Métis leaders here in Manitoba.
Putting it face to face with us is the answer, and that's properly telling the true story of really what happened.
This summer, the city of Victoria removed a statue of Macdonald as an act of reconciliation, prompting national discussion and debate over removing other Macdonald references and honours. The Angus Reid Institute surveyed 1,500 Canadians on their thoughts. 70% were opposed.
Massively, Canadians are not prepared to buy into and want to actually put out this wildfire of removal of names and images.
Opposition to removing the statue was highest among conservatives, but nationally, opinions on whether to put it back were split. Some historians say that means Canadians are starting to see Macdonald in a different light.
And I'm not necessarily in favor of taking down the statues, but what that means is there's an ever-growing number of Canadians who are critically thinking about our past.
Now, one of Sir John A. Macdonald's legacies was residential schools. About 57% of respondents say Canada has spent too much time apologizing, while about the same number say they support the notion of a National Day of Remembrance, while at the same time still remembering Sir John A. Cameron McIntosh, CBC News, Winnipeg.